Sir Henry.
How can I help you, Franklin?
I've come to talk about these travelers.
What about them?
May I ask, what are your intentions?
My intentions?
Why are you holding them?
Well, because they have seen too much.
And what are you going to do with them? Sacrifice them?
Such a possibility exists, I see no reason why I shouldn't consider it.
These outsiders have not made this bargain. It is wrong to punish them with the curse we brought on ourselves. It's murder.
How dare you?
So it is your intention?
My intention, Franklin, is, as always, to do all that is necessary to protect this town and the people in it. Now, should I do this thing, then Stephen Chandler, one of our very own, will have the opportunity to live another 2 years, perhaps even four if we find the others. How can you possibly argue with that?
Are you telling me the ceremony is rigged, Sir Henry? That the Chosen One can be changed at will, your will?
The audacity you have to question me on these matters. I am this town's magistrate, and
don't throw that title at me, Bartlett. I was there when it was given to you.
Yes, but it was given to me.
It was taken.
Get out.
A magi wanted to be magistrate. Then suddenly a mysterious plague befalls our town, forcing our hand to anoint the only one that has the power to stop it.
That is enough. Be careful, Franklin.
Or what? You'll choose me next?
You walk a very dangerous line, my friend.
There is a growing number of us who feel this should end. We should stand up to the ogre once and for all.
You should kill the ogre and stop making the sacrifice. It's a ridiculous dream of a child.
Every year, one of us is eaten. That is a nightmare.
Yes, that is exactly why I was made magistrate, because I knew that none of you would have the will to do that which is necessary.
And what's that? We sacrifice for your eternal life.
We're all in this together. Franklin, at least you forget, we do not grow in number. I, too, will die.
And who will be the one to chain you to the stockade?